Hello everyone and welcome to our session for the third secondary year sociology and economics section. In this mathematics chapter, we will continue with functions of economics and social sciences. This is the second session in this chapter. We said before that this chapter is divided into three parts about the cost, revenue, profit, demand and supply, and the depreciation of an asset. In the first session, we talked about the cost, and in this session, we are going to talk about the revenue and the profit functions. By the end of this session, you will be able to calculate the revenue, the profit, the maximum and the minimum profit, the maximum loss of an enterprise, company or factory. We will also be able to determine the break-even level of an enterprise, company or factory, and we will interpret these results economically. So in our first session, we talked about the cost. We said that the cost is the amount of money an enterprise has to pay in order to produce items. We first talked about the total cost. We said it's a function in terms of X, where X is the number of units produced by the enterprise, and CT of X is equal to CF plus CV of X, where CF is the fixed cost, which is the cost independent of the number of produced items, and CV is the variable cost, which depends on the quantity produced. We also said that CV of 0 is equal to 0, so the variable cost is equal to 0 when no items are produced. We also said that to calculate the fixed cost, we need to find the total cost when X is equal to 0. The average cost, it's the cost of one unit, which is given by the function C bar of X equals CT of X over X. So I need to divide by the number of units in order to know the cost of one unit. The marginal cost given by CT of X plus 1 minus CT of X and denoted MC of X, it's the cost of the X plus first unit. So after we're producing X units, the cost of producing the next unit, which is the X plus first unit, will be the marginal cost. And we said that for large amounts of production, this marginal cost will become the derivative of the total cost function, which is more used in exercises since the amount of production will be large enough. Now we are going to start with the revenue. What is the revenue? The revenue is the amount of money received by an enterprise for selling a specific amount of items. So it is defined by the total revenue of the enterprise assured by the sale of X units. The revenue function is defined by the price of one article, because in exercises usually the given price will be the price of an article, divided by the unit of total cost. And why do we divide by the unit of the total cost? To make sure that the revenue function and the cost function have the same unit, then multiplied by X into the unit of X. And what is X into unit of X? It gives the total number of items that are sold multiplied by the percent of selling. Sometimes they will tell in the question that all the products were sold. Sometimes a specific percent was sold. This is why you need to multiply by the percent of selling. Now this is an example. Again, we have the rule and we need to do a direct application on this rule. An enterprise produces a certain article with the given total cost function. X is the produced quantity. Again, X is between 0 and 5. They told us if each article is sold for 4,000 Lebanese lira and the entire production is sold. Now, this is very important. When they say the entire production is sold, this means that 100% of the production is sold, because we need to put it in the rule. Express R of X in millions of Lebanese lira in terms of X. Notice that the unit over here is same as the unit for the total cost. So we have R of X. Let's start filling the rule exactly as written above. So the price of one article, which is 4,000 Lebanese lira, divided by the unit of the total cost, which is 1 million, multiplied by X, and here X is X, since I want R of X in terms of X. So I'm going to keep it X, but it's multiplied by the unit of X. And what is the unit of X? I can find it in the given. It's in thousands of articles, so it's 1,000. And then multiplied by the percent of selling. And what's the percent of selling over here? If the entire production is sold, so it's 100%. By simplifying this product, I get 4X in millions of Lebanese lira. Now, a very important note. Notice that R of 0 is equal to 0. And why is that? Since X is a factor in this rule, so R of x when I replace x by 0 will be equal to 0, which means that the curve representing the revenue function is always a curve passing through the origin 0, 0 in the coordinate system. Now we will start with the profit. And what is the profit? The profit function is what the enterprise is gaining by the selling of items. It's not all the amount of money that the enterprise is receiving. And why is that? This money received by the enterprise is composed of two parts. One part of this money is to cover the expenses which the enterprise paid for the production, and then the extra money will represent the profit. This is why the profit function is basically the difference between the total revenue function, which is the whole sum of money received by the enterprise, minus the total cost, which is what the enterprise paid for the production. It's also known as the total algebraic profit. And why is that? Because it can represent a gain if it's positive, it can represent a loss if it's negative, or neither if it's zero. So the profit function, it's the difference between the revenue and the total cost function. So it's R of X minus CT of X. Note that the values of X that give zero profit, after which the enterprise starts to gain money, which means after the enterprise collects all the money they already paid for the production and they start to get profit, these points are called the break-even points. So when the question is, when does the enterprise attain the break-even level? You must be looking at points for which P of X is equal to zero. And if you want to see it graphically, if you have the graph of P of X, the point at which the graph meets the x-axis is a break-even point. So these are the points at which the profit is zero. Let's see what will happen if the profit was positive or negative. So if the profit is positive, it means the enterprise is realizing a gain. Just like in this graph, notice that the profit or the curve representing the profit is above the x-axis for all values of x, which means that the profit is positive and the enterprise is achieving a gain. On the other hand, if P of X was negative, which means the curve representing the profit is below the x-axis, this means that the enterprise is realizing a loss. In other words, the revenue achieved by this enterprise is less than what they paid for the production, so it's less than the total cost. Now, when the derivative of the profit function is equal to zero at a specific value of x, then it's probable that the profit is either minimum or maximum. And why is that? Because I get a change in the variation of the function, so the function is attaining an extremum point. We are going to talk about it in details. Notice this first example. So the function is increasing and then it's decreasing. It achieves a maximum point. Notice that this maximum point is a positive value. So it's above the x-axis, which means we have a maximum profit. And in this example, notice that the profit function starts decreasing and then it increases after attaining a specific minimum. And this minimum has a positive value. So since the profit function has a positive minimum, it means that the enterprise achieves a minimum profit. Now, in this example, notice that the profit function attains a minimum. If you look at the graph, you will see a minimum value since the function started to decrease and then it increased after reaching this minimum. But this minimum value is a negative value. This is why we say that the enterprise realizes its maximum loss. So it loses to the maximum and then it starts to increase again. Now, let's see a numerical example in calculation. We're using the same enterprise with the same total cost function. We calculated previously that the revenue of this enterprise is 4x. We need to express P of X in terms of X. And then we're given the table of variation of the function. We have to determine the maximum profit in Lebanese lira and the number of articles sold associated with this maximum. Let's start with the first part. So we need to express P of X in terms of X. And what is P of X? It's the profit function, which is the difference between the total cost function and the revenue function, which will give us negative X squared plus 3X minus 1 in millions of Lebanese lira. Now in part 2, we need to use the given table to determine the maximum profit and the number of articles associated with this maximum. Notice that when you have P of X, if you find the derivative of P of X, and you solve it, you get that P of X attains a maximum point when X is equal to 1.5 since its derivative will be 0. So I have the exact values for which p prime of x is equal to 0, and I have its corresponding value of p of x. I'm going to replace the maximum profit in this case will be 1.25, the value obtained by replacing x, which is equal to 1.5 in the profit function, multiplied by the unit, which is the millions of Lebanese lira, which will give me 1,250,000 Lebanese lira. The number of articles sold is 1.5 in thousands. So remember to use the respective units of x and that of ct of x. So we had to find the maximum profit. So we needed to find the derivative p prime of x. We already found p of x. And after we find it, we solve it. We find its roots. We got one root at 1.5. The function p prime of x will be increasing and then decreasing since x squared had a negative coefficient. And since it's changing its variation, then it has a maximum point at x equals 1.5 with a value of profit that is equal to 1.25. We used them in calculation and we got these answers. Now, what about the average revenue? Just like we have the average cost, which is the cost per one unit, now we have the average revenue or the unit revenue, R bar, which is the revenue assured from selling one unit among the x sold units. And how do I find it? I need to divide by x. So R bar of x is equal to R of x over x. Similarly, what is the average profit? It's the profit attained by selling one unit among the x sold units. So it's denoted P bar of x and it's equal to P of x over x. Now what about the marginal revenue and the marginal profit? The marginal revenue is the revenue achieved or assured from selling the x plus first unit. So x units are already sold. Selling the x plus first unit will give a revenue, which is the marginal revenue, denoted MR. And it's found by the derivative of the revenue function. So MR of x is equal to R prime of x. Similarly, the marginal profit, it's the profit assured from selling the x plus first unit. It's denoted MP of x and it's equal to P prime of x. Let's do a numerical example. With the same enterprise, I already calculated R of x. I already found it in terms of x. It's 4x and I found P of x, which is equal to negative x squared plus 3x minus 1. The following questions are about the average profit and the marginal profit. Of course, you can have the same questions related to the revenue. Let's start solving them. In number 1, we need to express P bar of x in terms of x. P bar of x is the average profit and it's found when I divide P of x by x. So I have it in this way, in millions of Lebanese lira. I don't forget to write the unit. In part 2, I have a numerical application, so I need to replace x by 2. P bar of 2 is equal to 0.5 in millions of Lebanese lira. And an economic interpretation of this result is that the common profit assured from selling one unit out of the two units mentioned in this part is 500,000 Lebanese lira. Now in numbers 3 and 4, we must find the marginal profit. So the marginal profit is the derivative of the profit function. So I found it. It's negative 2x plus 3 in millions of Lebanese lira. And a numerical application, we're replacing x by 1. We got the marginal profit when x is equal to 1 is equal to 1 million Lebanese lira. So 1 million Lebanese lira is the profit assured from selling the second unit. Why? Since x is equal to 1, so one unit is already sold. Selling the second unit will give a profit of 1 million Lebanese lira. This was the end of the session. To do more exercises on the profit, revenue and cost, you can refer to page 265 in your textbook, problems 2 to 6. Thank you for your attention, stay safe, and wait the next sessions in which we will continue our lessons about functions of economic and social sciences. Thank you.